when I found out people would pay me to DJ and they would fly me places, I was just like, fuck it, I'm gonna keep doing this. And I honed my skills and I got better at it. And I just tried to take advantage of that opportunity. I didn't expect to have any success. I never aimed for it. When it did happen, I was really lucky, I felt like. And it keeps happening. I'm not really out there, you know, in the rat race trying to make hit records. I'm just doing what I do, and if people like it, I'm happy with it.
Major Lazer.
So as Diplo, I just feel like my strength is the mixing things up, you know? I'm not a musician per se, but I'm able to like say, you should do this with this person and try a little bit of this there, and I'm like a cook, you know? And that's kind of like where my gift lies, is in the weirdness. When you take chances, it's cool, because I have loads of accidents and you get to build them into something substantial. And that's what we do in our records, you know? Try to make something sound a bit goofy, and then we fix it up to sound clean, and, you know, just taking chances and having experiments.
Let me see your bestest wine. Lady, get in line. Let me see your bestest wine.
With Major Lazer, that project was like sort of a hobby for me. I was willing to dance hall and I was into punk rock, so we kind of combined the two together with that project. No one was doing music like that, so we got some success and we traveled and played the show live and got linked with Interscope to put the record out, and now we're just lucky to keep moving it forward and keep doing crazy stuff with it. You might hear some of the records, like say Pawn the Floor, which is a crazy club record, but the advent of that is like really mixing dancehall and punk rock, and you can hear it when you hear the whole ethos of the record, and you might look at the artwork and kind of see how we put it together. I work on so many different types of music, you know? I might work hard on a pop record so I can have money to spend on like some weird-ass punk shit. That's what keeps you fresh. A lot of people, if they're doing pop music, they burn out quick because they're chasing the next cool sound, you know? And a lot of people, like, you might chase our sound, but we don't ever aim to, like, have a sound that works. We just do different shit, and every year you might hear something different, but it's going to be sort of like that a really progressive sound that people will want to use later on. Sampling and digging for old records is definitely an inspiration for me. I'm from that school of hip-hop where if you don't know how to play music, you just loop it up and chop it up yourself. I'm digging for MP3s and digging for CDs and world music and whatever crazy stuff I can find, you know? People give me demos of South by Southwest, I listen to them, you know, see what's going on there and dig deeper. I just love learning about music. As much as I dig, as much as I find different places and travel and decipher different styles of music, I'm not surprised that I keep finding new genres that I, you know, things keep popping up, whether it's Africa or, you know, Scandinavia, Australia. There's always kind of new stuff coming out of nowhere. My job is to kind of keep on that and find those crazy styles and see what I can do with them.